Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the reading of War, Scary, and Fun Fest book, Rainbow Six, Conquer the Sea. Now we read on to chapter 11, I believe. Goodbye for now. Alexa Pierce. Last night, as I could recall, was one where I felt my primal sight of love, and when I woke up to see two beautiful polar sisters hugging me from each side with each of my arms acting like pillows for them. But this scene did not last long as I slowly moved my arms away from her. When Sophia's head hit the floor, she woke up and she was called by Eris, who mimicked her sister in some ways. Is it time to get up? Asked Sophia with a yawn, and I replied, yes, it made both girls pop, so I rejected that statement, allowing her to use my arms the same way they use the murderer. We'll have to do that again sometime, Ella cooed, which I jokingly remarked. Only if your sister doesn't drink me, we can do it again. I said, making Sophia chuckle before saying, of course, dear, I just wanted to test the drug to see if they can't. Your sex drive, and if I was more carefully, they were lower sex drive, so yeah. I wanted to see if it's higher about the pills.
Yes.
Oh my god. After that little talk, we separated and got our clothes on. I noticed the paper from earlier, deciding it was a good time to ask Sophia the question. I walked up to her while she was changing her clothes and asked, is this a position for your unit? She smirked and said, honey, that spot is reserved just for you. Reluctantly, I agreed to this, and signed the pen I took to somebody, handing it to her. She wanted me to pick her. When I did, she leaned forward and placed the tip around my snout, which caused my heart to lift again. But I caught myself the very next second and placed the floor back down, but she never returned to putting her clothes on, and walking out the door to her dorm. I hear the car come up behind me, but was quickly tripped by my tail. I turned around to see Ella on the floor, and I offered my hand to her sister, which she accepted, but I must have told her harder than anticipated, as the next thing I knew, she went face first into my tail while softly. Then I put a hand slither around my waist, and into my back pocket that I pretended not to notice after it. But Ella separated herself from me and walked away from me to the door, and when she got near the door, she looked behind her, threw me a kiss, and walked out the door, throwing her hips. Her hips to entice me, which almost activated my final instinct, but didn't at the same time. Once she was gone, I noticed the bathroom, and I went inside to go do my business. Once done, I went to wash my hands, but when I caught a glimpse of myself, I stopped to count how many scars I had, which came about 5 in the front, and I turned around and saw 6 more, but those scars held more value than mine knew why where I was. Then those weird sounds came as the sounds of spine-chilling machines followed by the unspeakable things the scientists have given me. Those noises quickly disappeared as I started to hear a voice call out to me, but by the sound of it, it was one of the groups that recorded the script and walked out of the bathroom while hearing that voice. I made all three feel silent, but the voice came near me when I saw Ella by my side with a word of expression. Are you alright? I heard something break and saw some recruits ran in terror from this direction, she said while pointing towards a group of soldiers muttering in terror at first. I wanted to walk up to them and apologize, but seeing their faces, that would make things worse. So I turned to Ella and asked if she can talk to them, which we agreed to. As she was talking to them, they seemed to calm down as some... And one of the children, something which caused her to walk up to me and ask me to blink, she asked, and I looked at her for a moment, which made her even more confused, but told me that the soldier saw my eyes. They rolled over to reveal a white side that turned from men into little boys. But as she was saying this, the intercom turned on with her voice saying something before turning off again. I looked at my shoulder and signaled me to follow her to the landing zone where a helicopter landed. After landing, it turned off its engines, opened the back door to the 36, and smiled. Well, actually, are you ready? I told him to wait as I turned for a red and hugged it before being interrupted by Sophia, who motioned me to do the same thing. So I decided to give them both a hug, and after nuzzling both their heads as a sign of affection, I turned to Sook saying, "Alright, I'm ready," and climbed aboard the helicopter. But as the engines were starting up, I ran to the sisters who blew me a kiss, which I caught with both hands, putting them in one hand and then placing them into my heart. After that, the helicopter took off and Six briefed me on what to expect at my new base. After a while, Six handed me a box of gift wrap, saying it was a welcoming gift. Once I opened it, the box had a label, "You're welcome." Once I opened the box, I saw the flat thing Six told me was the new phone, bought by Six for purposes other than it was originally intended for. And that is it, ladies and gentlemen. Chapter 11, I do believe, also known as Goodbye for Now. Now, just in a few minutes, we will have someone else read the next chapter. I hope you like this very much, and please, work on your own time. Thank you, and goodbye.
Woo! Yeah, historical, we love you!
Oh, yeah!